Hello, my beautiful butterflies. It's Quinn, and today I'm going to show you a compilation of paranormal TikToks slash shorts that I have done throughout a whole year. So stick around. By the time you'll be seeing this, I'll be married already. But as of right now, while I'm filming this, I am not married yet. We are getting married, or technically have gotten married by the time that this video goes up, October, Friday the 13th. I'm going on my honeymoon to the Winchester House in San Jose, so I will be putting in some shorts on my Reels or on TikTok, so keep an eye out for those. But without further ado, let's get on to the paranormal TikTok shorts that I created throughout a whole year of having haunted items. Part one of asking my haunted doll Amelia questions that you guys have. Amelia, are you here with me? All right. Amelia, are you a good spirit? A positive spirit? Yes. If you guys didn't know, Amelia is haunted by a little girl. She passed at the age of 10 years old. I'm slowly getting her story together, but I don't know exactly what to ask, so if you guys have any questions, make sure to comment them. And hit follow so you can follow our journey. Amelia, are you here? Yes. Amelia, do you remember where you used to live? Yes. Did you live in the United States? Yes. Do you remember what state you used to live in? This is my haunted doll, Amelia. She chose to inhabit this doll because it looks a lot like her when she was alive. This doll has a heart-shaped face, black hair, curly, and dark brown eyes. Asking my haunted doll Amelia questions that you guys have. Amelia, did you live around here? No. Amelia, do you consider me your friend? Yes. Amelia, do you know what city we're in? Have you ever lived in California before? No. Asking my haunted doll Amelia questions about her past life. Amelia, do you remember anything about your past life? Yes. Did you have any siblings? Yes. One sibling? Siblings? Yes, four siblings. Was your father ever abusive towards you? Yes. Was your mother ever abusive towards you? No. Today we're going to be asking my haunted doll questions about her past life. Did you get to go to school growing up? Were you homeschooled growing up? Yes. I have a feeling that her mom probably homeschooled her, not her father. And if he did, he probably wasn't too good about if she got a bad grade. That's just what I'm feeling in my gut, but we'll ask her. Amelia, am I right about your mom teaching you? Homeschooling you? About her past life. Amelia, did you live longer than your siblings? Yes. Did your siblings
die of sicknesses? No. Were your siblings murdered? Yes. Amelia, if you're comfortable answering, were you murdered? Yes. You told me your dad was abusive. Did he kill you? Yes. Getting answers from my haunted doll Amelia to questions that you guys asked. Amelia, are you going to haunt my family? No. Amelia, will you protect my family? Amelia, will you protect our followers? Our butterfly family? Yes. Today I'm going to show you what I use to communicate with Amelia. She'll make candles flicker. I also have a pendulum made with tiger's eye. It came with this cute board to help her communicate through it. I have this light-up cat ball that senses motion, and she's only used it like once so far. And of course my dowsing rods with the evil eye that I painted onto them. And I also have a light-up bear coming in the mail that senses motion and touch. I also plan on getting a REM pod and a music box. And we're gonna be making YouTube videos! So go subscribe if you haven't already. Asking my haunted doll questions about her passing. Basically, out of everything that I've gathered so far, I know that her dad killed her. And possibly her siblings as well. She was the last one to be alive, but that's all I know. Amelia, did you die in a car accident by your father's hand? No. Amelia, were you drowned? No. Amelia, were you shot? So I can't pose the last question I asked her, but this is what she said. Asking my haunted doll questions about her past life. Amelia, do you ever still think about your siblings? Yes. Do you think fondly of them? Yes. If you're comfortable answering, are either of your parents still alive? Asking my haunted doll questions about her siblings. Amelia, so you said you lived past them. Does that mean you were older than them? When you died and they died? No. If you're comfortable answering this, does that just mean that you were the last one that was killed? Amelia, were you the youngest? No. Middle child. Did Amelia die on the Titanic? Well, from my gatherings, she's died from her father's hand. She had four siblings, which she lived past, and her father was really abusive. So in short term, no. I don't believe that she died on the Titanic unless he put her on there. But I'm still definitely trying to figure out Amelia's story, so comment any questions that you may have for her. So why does Amelia choose to haunt this vessel? And why doesn't she move on into the light? Amelia, have you seen the light? Have you seen, quote, heaven's gates? Yes. Amelia, do you want to go into the light? No. Is there a reason for you wanting to stay? No. Okay. Amelia, do you kind of just like hanging out here on Earth? Yes. Hi everyone, I'm Quinn, and I'm going to be sharing a bit of my haunted to tell Amelia's story that I figured out so far. So Amelia lived around the time of Abraham Lincoln's presidency. She remembers Abraham Lincoln dying sometime around the time she was living. This means her birthday may date all the way back to 1851, but my friend and I are feeling more that it's around 1856 or 1857. Amelia had a father who was a mother who was caring, and four siblings, two boys and two girls. She was only 10 years old when she was, and she was a middle child. She was eventually the last to be by her father's hand. After her father ended up dumping them into some kind of body of water off of a boat. It goes on and on and on.
Start to dance and I'm singing like, oh, I want something just like this.
I'll be over now, but I feel it still.
But I always
have
a feeling,
feeling. Duh. I want you to be happier,
because I'm happy.
Asking my haunted doll what she may have seen at the bunker experience with Chris and Kelsey Davies. Amelia, did you see Ronnie's grandpa? Yes, she did. Ronnie is the friend that went with me to Pasadena and got in contact with her grandfather through Kelsey Davies. My whole experience with the bunker will be up on YouTube on Halloween, so make sure to check that out. Amelia, did you see the shadowy figure? Yes. Did you play with the little girl Sarah at all while we were there? This is my haunted statue, but I don't know what his name is. I brought this statue down to Pasadena to meet Kelsey Davies and see if she felt the same energy that I did, and she did. There is a light positive energy that comes off of this statue, and I don't know if it's a little boy or a man or maybe even a dog. Now, I don't know if dogs or animals, pets, can inhabit or do inhabit any objects ever. I thought they may follow their owners around, but I don't know. It's a possibility. I'm gonna do some more research and ask Kelsey and Chris what they think. Today I'm gonna be asking my haunted statue a few questions to figure out a little bit more about him. Is he an adult? Little boy? Is it even a boy at all? Is it a woman? Let's figure it out. If you were raised as a boy, open the rods, and if you were raised as a girl, cross the rods. Boy. Are you a little boy? Today I found out that my haunted statue is indeed a teenage boy. Now we're going to be trying to figure out his name, or at least what it starts with. Does your name start with an A, B, or C? No. Does your name start with a D, H, or I? J-K-L? No. M-N-O-P? Yes. So we found out that my haunted statue's name starts with M-N-O or P. The other night, I had the name Nate come to mind, or Nathaniel, and I'm not 100% sure that that's his name, but we're gonna, like, figure out which letter that his name starts with. Does your name start with an M? No. Does your name start with an N? Yes. Okay. asking my haunted statue, Nate, if he enjoyed meeting Kelsey Davies. Nate, did you enjoy meeting Kelsey Davies down in Pasadena? Yes. Did you see any other spirits down in the bunker? Yes. Did you enjoy hearing us be stupid and laugh our asses off after the seance? Being a teenager, did you feel like you fit into our goofiness? Yeah. Let's figure out if my haunted doll and statue get along. Amelia, do you like Nate? You don't have to say yes. Yeah, she likes him. Nate, do you like Amelia? Is she nice to be around? Yeah. Now you better treat each other like siblings, okay? Is that cool with y'all? Today we're going to be figuring out my haunted doll Amelia's birthday. Amelia was alive during Abraham Lincoln's presidency, and she remembers him getting shot. I've been doing the Estes method on my own time, and I've kind of pinpointed her birthdays. Amelia, were you born in August? Yes. Amelia, were you born on the 17th of August? Yes. Amelia, were you born in 1856? Yes. In this video, we're going to be asking Amelia some questions that you guys commented. Amelia, do you feel safe around me? Yes.
This bird won't stop.
Amelia, do you want revenge on your dad for what he did to you?
No.
Amelia, have you recently visited any of our followers?
Yeah, she checks up on you guys.
Asking my haunted statue about his past life. Nate, do you remember what year you were born in? Yes. Did you pass within the last 30 years? No. Did you pass over 50 years ago? Yes. Nate, are we related in any way? Asking my haunted doll what state she's from. My neighbors are currently having a party, so if you can hear anything in the background, it's them. Amelia, did you live in California? No. Amelia, did you live in Texas? No. Amelia, did you live in Florida? Double confirmation. Amelia, did you live in what is now known as Florida? Yes.
So after doing some research about her state when she was alive, I found that Florida became the third southern state to separate from the Union in November 1860. which is the year that Abraham Lincoln was elected as president.
For those of you who haven't put it together, Amelia is a black little 10-year-old girl who was most likely a slave back then during Abraham Lincoln's presidency. This video is getting a little long, so come back for part two.
In the last video, we found out that my haunted doll Amelia is from Florida. Florida was the third southern state to separate itself from the Union. And obviously, during that time, there was a lot of slavery. Slavery was considered normal. And if you haven't put it together yet, Amelia is a little 10-year-old black girl. She and her family were slaves, and her father ended up unaliving her a year after Abraham Lincoln was. And that makes me wonder if the end of Abraham Lincoln's presidency was a kind of reason that her father ended up unaliving her and the rest of her family.
And Lincoln died in 1865. Amelia was born in 1856,
so she was still alive at least 1 year after he was assassinated. What do you guys think?
Here's a bit of my haunted statue Nate's backstory.
Nate was born in the early 1900s. And he specifically told me that he was young, white, and rich. He also has an Irish background. I know he at least has one sister. Her name is Marjorie. And then I got one more name from the spirit box, and I'm gonna totally butcher it. Nicola? Nicola? I know I said it wrong. Now, I don't know if that's another sister or maybe his mother, but he struggles to talk about her. I think she, maybe he, maybe both of them died in a car crash at some point in the morning is what he told me. Since it's a sensitive topic for him, I'm not gonna pull the answers out of him, but we will slowly put a story together.
Asking my haunted statue Nate about the car accident. Nate, did you die in the morning time? Yes. Nate, did you die in a car accident? Yes. Yes, he did. Were there other people with you in the car?
In the last video, we found out that Nate died in a car accident, and there were other people in it, so let's ask him a few more questions.
Nate, did a loved one of yours die in the car accident with you? Yes. Was it a sister of yours? Yes. Was your mom in the car as well? Yes. Was your dad in the car? Yes. Was there anyone else in the car? Yes. Asking my haunted statue Nate about the car crash he passed away in. In the last video, we found out that Nate's parents and his sister were in the car when he got into an accident and died. But there was also someone else in that car. Nate, was there another sister in the car with you or brother? No. Did you guys have a personal chauffeur? Was that everyone who was in the car? No. I keep getting this feeling that his girlfriend was in the car, but I don't even know if he had one. Asking my haunted statue Nate if he had a girlfriend. Nate, did you have a girlfriend? Yes. Was she the other person that was in the car accident with you? Did she die in the car accident? No. I keep seeing a picture of a girl in a hospital. hospital bed in my head. And for some reason, I also feel like she was in a coma. Did the car crash send your girlfriend into a coma? Yes. That's so sad.
Today we're going to be asking my haunted doll Amelia about her likes and her dislikes.
Amelia, do you have a favorite genre of music?
Yes, she does.
Amelia, did your favorite genre of music come from back when you were alive?
No.
Amelia, is your favorite genre of music from the present? Like right now?
Yes. Asking what my haunted doll's likes and dislikes are.
Part 2.
Amelia, do you have a genre of music that you hate?
No. Okay.
Amelia, did you get to play outside when you were little? Yes, she did. Did you have a favorite thing to play outside? No. Amelia, did you like learning? Yes, she did.
You frickin' nerd! Asking my haunted statue Nate about his likes and his dislikes. I also have the Scare Bear with me, so I'm gonna turn it on and set it on the table and we'll see if it goes off. Nate is more active than Amelia, at least with playing with gadgets. And I have a pretty crazy story about this Scare Bear, so if you guys want to hear it, let me know.
Nate, do you have a favorite color? Yes, he does. Nate, is your favorite color in the rainbow? Yes, it is. Nate, is your favorite color red? Yes. Is there a color you dislike?
Asking my haunted statue Nate about his likes and his dislikes.
Part 2.
Nate, is there a color that you don't like? Yes, there is. Is the color that you don't like also in the rainbow? Yes, it is. Nate, is your least favorite color orange? No. Okay. Nate, is your least favorite color yellow? Yes, it is. Okay. Nate, do you like blondes? Yes, you do. Nate, was your girlfriend a blonde? Yeah, she was.
Asking my haunted doll questions, y'all commented.
Amelia, do you know the song WAP?
Yeah.
Do you like the song WAP?
Yes? You're 10!
We are gonna have a talk tonight, young lady. Amelia, do you like the band Slayer?
Yes, she does.
We've got a rocker chick on our hands, guys. Amelia, did you have any friends growing up? Yes, she did.
Kelsey Davies held seances in October and I went to one.
We only welcome love and light.
Welcome, spirits. We come here with the utmost respect.
We're asking to be protected.
Please show yourself now.
You're okay?
Yeah.
Are you getting choked up?
Yeah. Like, I can't breathe.
Whoa!
Oh my god.
Whoa!
Oh my god.
I have goosebumps everywhere.
Wait,
there's a pause.
Oh, shit. It's just one of them. It's
guys, the no one touched this light. No, and it is.
Oh my
sweet.
God.
Yours was wrong. Mine will not go off.
Asking my haunted doll what she thinks about the different nominees of the Grammys.
Amelia, do you like the song Pushing Pete? Yes, she does. Do you think it should win Best Rap Song at the Grammys? Yes, she does. Amelia, do you have have a favorite nominee for Album of the Year? Yes, she does. Is it by ABBA? No. Is it by Adele? No. Is it Queen Beyoncé? No. Asking my haunted doll what she thinks of the different nominees at the Grammys 2023. Part 2! We are talking about the Best Album of the Year award. Amelia doesn't think that ABBA, Adele, and Beyoncé should win for Best Album. So who does she think should win? Should Mary J's song win? No. Do you think the album You and Me on the Rock should win? No. Okay. What about Doja Cat Woman? Yes, you want that song to win? So just double confirmation. You think Doja Cat should win the Grammy for Best Album of the Year? Yes, she does. All right. Asking my haunted statue, Nate, what he thinks of the different nominees at the Grammys. Nate, do you know what the Grammys is? Yes, he does.
Good, we're asking questions about it today.
Do you know who's been nominated for Best Album of the Year? Yes, he does. Nate, do you have a favorite or do you have someone that you think should win? Yes, he does. Do you think Harry's House by Harry Styles should win? No? Okay. Asking my haunted statue, Nate, who he thinks should win Best Album of the Year award at the Grammys 2023. Part 2! Well, we know it's not Harry Styles, so let's move on to asking him about the Queen. Y'all know who I'm talking about. Do you think the album Special by Lizzo should win for Best Album of the Year award? Are you saying no, sir? No? Okay, what about Coldplay? You want Coldplay to win? So you think Music of the Spheres is the best album of the year and should win? Yup. Cause I knew that was the last time, the last time. Oh,
oh.
Asking my haunted statue, Nate, questions about his girlfriend. I have new spiritual communication tools, so if you see any of them going off, make sure to comment. Nate, did your girlfriend go into the light after she passed? Yes, she did. Does she ever come and visit you, or is that even possible after she's moved on? No. Okay. Nate, do you want to go into the light? No. Okay. Nate, is there a deeper reason for you wanting to stay? No. You just like hanging out here, Nate? Yeah. Deep diving into my haunted doll Amelia's past. Today I'm going to be asking her questions about her mother. If you haven't seen the other videos into Amelia's backstory, I highly suggest you check them out. Her father unalived her and the rest of her siblings, and so much more.
Amelia, did your father kill your mother when he killed you? No, he did not. Amelia, did your mother die before you? Yes. Was your mother's death natural? No. I keep seeing a woman being killed by a white man. I'm guessing that's her mother. This is a deep dive into my haunted doll Amelia's past. Her mother died before her and it was not in a natural way. I kept seeing a woman being beaten and I feel like that was her mother. I see a large white man hitting her. I don't know if that was before her mother's death or if that's how she died. Amelia, those visions that I'm seeing, is that of your mother? Yes. Is a beating from your master what killed her? Yes. It's so sad that she went through that. Do you want to stop talking about this now?
So I've been wondering this for a minute now. If the AI portrait filter can pick up ghosts, did it pick up Nate and turn him into a girl? Or is that just a random ghost in my apartment? Let's ask my haunted objects.
Amelia and Nate, do you remember making the AI video? The AI filter video? Yes, they do. Did the filter pick up your spirits? Yes, strong yes. Nate, the photo in the bathroom, was that of you? Yes, so it did just turn him into a girl. Thank God there's not a random lady in my apartment.
Oops, got your coping skills. Now let's see what we got. That's not a coping skill.
Today I'm going to be asking my haunted statue, Nate, what his birthday is. I know that Nate was born in the early 1900s and died in a car accident, but I don't know how long later, I don't know how old he is. I know he's a teenager, but let's try to figure that all out today.
Nate, are you older than 15 years old?
Yes, he is.
Nate, are you 16 years old? Quick no for that one. Nate, are you 17 years old? Yes, he is.
Asking my haunted statue when his birthday is.
Part 2.
In the last video, we found out Nate's age, and now we're going to find out what month, maybe what day, and definitely what year he was born. Nate, were you born in the first 6 months of the year? Yes, he was. Okay, that'll make it easier for me. Nate, were you born in January? No, he was not. Nate, were you born in February? That's a no. Okay. Follow or subscribe for part 3. This is part 3 of asking my haunted statue when his birthday is. We know he's born in the first 6 months of the year, but not January or February. Nate, were you born in March? Yes? No? Let me re-ask that. Nate,
Were you born in March? I think that's a yes. Nate, were you born in the first 10 days of March? That's a no. Were you born sometime between the 11th and the 20th? This is part 4 of asking my haunted statue when his birthday is. We've got the month down, now we just gotta work on the day. Nate, were you born sometime from the 11th to the 20th? Yes. Okay. Nate, were you born on the 11th? No. Nate, were you born on the 12th? No. Okay. Nate, were you born on the 16th? Yes, he was. Follow or subscribe to find out what year he was born. My haunted statue, Nate, died in a car crash at the age of 17. He was born March 17th, but we don't know what year he was born. Nate was alive during the early 1900s, but that's all I know. Oh, and he was rich. He would want me to tell you that. The kid has an ego on him. Nate, were you born before 1910? No. Okay. Nate, were you born before 1920? Yes. Okay. Were you born in 1911? Yes. Well, shit. Boy's got a birthday coming up.
Pretty much started this entire family. No one would be anywhere or anything without me.
Nice to one these Jose on that jerk shit. Yeah, bitch, you cool, but you ain't better than a perk, bitch.
Yes, I'm the biggest B-I-T-C-H. Wanna race Tokyo Drift in my race. I wanna ride, come get on my face. She a loser, better.
Nice to one these Jose on that jerk shit. Yeah, bitch, you cool, but you ain't better than a perk, bitch.
Maybe because you're skinny, and maybe because you're pretty, you're used to getting away with things. But I want you to know that your actions have an effect on others, and I hate you, and you are a horrible person. And you not understanding that you're a horrible person doesn't make you less of a horrible person.
You think I'm pretty?
I am your mother. I am your mother. You listen to me.
You listen to me.
Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening.
Today I'm going to be asking my haunted photo, Mary, about her death. So I've been watching some YouTube videos and letting my haunted objects react, and Mary has been reacting to the word elevator a lot. Maybe she died in an elevator, maybe someone she knew died in an elevator, I don't know. But I'm going to ask her if maybe that's what it's about. Only those of love and light are allowed to come through. Only Mary. Mary, did you die in an elevator? She did. Oh my goodness. Were you trapped in the elevator for a long period of time? No. Today I'm going to be asking my haunted photo, Mary, about her death. Mary, were you unalived in an elevator? Were you killed? Yes, she was. Mary, if you're comfortable telling me, were you stabbed in an elevator? She was. Did anyone try to save you? Did you know the person that tried to save you? No. Mary, did you know the person that killed you? Yes. Asking my haunted photo, Mary, about her death. For some reason, I'm having a feeling it's a loved one. I don't know if it's like an ex-boyfriend or a brother or a cousin. I don't know, someone she loved. Someone she trusted. Am I correct about that, Mary? Instantaneous, yes. Was it an ex-boyfriend? Or a boyfriend? Because I know you didn't want to get married. Yes. Since she wasn't the kind of woman that wanted to settle down and get married and have children, I wonder if he got mad about that. I have a feeling he did. Today I'm going to be asking my haunted photo, Mary, about her death. Mary, did he kill you because you didn't want to marry him? You weren't ready to marry him? Wow. Mary, was he ever violent before this? No. Would he be verbally abusive to you? Yeah. I'm seeing, like, this man run out of an elevator. Like, he just did it when no one was there and ran away. Today I'm gonna be asking my haunted photo, Mary, about her death. I'm seeing, like, this man run out of an elevator. Like, he just did it when no one was there and ran away. Is that what happened, Mary? He just took a chance when no one was around and then ran away once the elevator doors opened or he could get off? So fucked up. Did anyone ever see him? Was he ever caught? Well, that's good. Mary, do you want to continue talking about this? No, I know. That's okay.
What did I ever do to you?
I'm blowing her back out, WWE, and she fucking with me, pussy, I smack that gang. Oh, I love it and I hate it at the same time. You and I
hadn't gone as I planned. When you had to bid adieu, said you'd never love anew. Bid adieu, said you'd never love anew. I wondered if I could hold it gone as I planned. When you had to bid adieu, said you'd never love anew. I wondered.
Can I talk my shit again? Can I talk my shit again?
How bad can I be? How bad could I possibly be? Let's see. All the customers are back.
Kylie, go. Good job, Kylie. You're doing amazing, sweetie. Wow, look at her go.
Objection. Nuh-uh. Fuck you mean, nuh-uh.
You ever feel like you fucked up somewhere a long time ago? You're living the wrong life, like a bad version of the life you're supposed to have.
Objection! Nuh-uh. Fuck you mean, nuh-uh.
So I bought another haunted doll. I don't have her yet, not in my possession at the moment of filming this. I have some information about her so far, and I thought you guys might want to know a little bit about her before she gets here. This is what she looks like. She has a mechanism in her eyes so that when she's tilted a certain way that they close. Someone that I very much look up to, Sol Mori, which I will try to tag if I can, has two dolls just like this that are haunted. And sometimes they close their eyes, even when they're not being touched. So I thought she would be a great addition to the family to be able to catch some paranormal activity for you guys. Anyway, let's get on to this haunted doll's story. Her name is Jenna. This is Jenna, and she is a haunted doll that I recently purchased. If you haven't seen part one, make sure to check that out. It has a little bit of information on what kind of doll she is. But now let's get into her story. Meet Jenna. Jenna's a sweetheart who was born in the late 1800s, kind of around when Amelia was alive. Her mother passed away during childbirth, so Jenna was only raised by her father. When Jenna got older, she got very curious about the medical field. She ended up enlisting and becoming a nurse during World War I. She was shocked when she got there. Seeing many men die made her throw up. She wanted to save them all, but even as a nurse, that was an impossible task. She was discharged a few years later, but she developed PTSD. She became a homebody, she stayed inside her house, and never even got married. Mary and her will have that in common. This is part three to Jenna's backstory. Jenna never got married, but was lucky enough to grow old. She died at the age of 73, peacefully in her sleep. She is a kind spirit that all she wants to do is protect. Since she gave up the dream of being a nurse, she wanted to be an author. Which is another thing that her and Mary will have in common and have a lot to talk about. And I guess the last person that had her would receive stories from dreams that Jenna would send through to them. From the moment I saw this doll, I knew I had to have her. I just felt such a connection and I just felt so drawn to her. So after asking my fiance and a little coercion, he let me buy her. She'll be here any day.
She just did it again and I freaking missed it. I freaking missed it and she did it again. None of them make this go off.
Caught him on camera. Oh my goodness, I love this question.
I think
you're a weird motherfucker. And you better not be a snitch, because I'll tell fucking Carl Bismarck.
I'm a snitch. Call Carl, I don't even know who he is.
He's dead!
Oh.
I see. I'm the problem.
I've dug two graves for us, my dear.
Gone as I planned. When you had to bid adieu, said you'd never love anew. I wondered if I could hold it and fall in love with it too.
Oh, I see. I'm the problem.
I've dug two graves for us, my dear.
What's up, G-Way? In the cut with my twin, we be vibing. Classy bitch, but they know I be outside with.
Oh, I see. I'm the problem.
I've dug two graves for us, my dear. Capitol, I was perfect living.
A full year of paranormal TikToks. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I love you guys very much, and if you have any questions for me, leave them down in the comments below, and I will get back to you as soon as I can, either with a TikTok video, a short, or just in the comments. And thank you all for watching. I love you, my beautiful butterflies.
Let's go get it.